Welcome back, everyone, to more The Witcher. All right, let's hike down to the festivities, the Mandragora. I think that's a pretty kicking track on the soundtrack. Pretty good, I think.
Reginald Aubrey has returned, not to be missed. Buy your ticket.
Just a few more ledges, and I shall get to Lucas's
court. Where? Oh, the alley. Geralt, you look spooky. Take off the mask.
Now, why does that not surprise me?
Ah! Little floaty lanterns.
Well, well. I did not expect you to have such a sense of style. My, my, Geralt. Not bad at all. And you've even a mask. Just not the kind required.
Huh?
They're a little different, the ones Mandragora members wear. I've brought you one. Put it on.
Yeah, I... My mask was a little spooky, I'll agree.
Any idea why they wear masks?
Likely because they imagine it oh so very romantic and mysterious. The truth is far simpler. This way, no one can tell which drunken aristocrats are pinching the performers.
Let's go. Soiree's started.
Mm-hmm. Wise of you to hide your weapons. They'd not have let us in otherwise, that's certain.
I didn't hide my weapons. Geralt did that automatically. Where'd I hide my weapons? In my infinite pocket holes? Mallet space?
How do we find the Cintrian? Have you a plan?
Key is not to spook him. Need to ask after his partner, Cecilia, first. Less likely to raise suspicions. As soon as we find her, we find him.
Right. Right you are. We must proceed with caution. Come. It's our turn.
Madame, Monsieur, an extraordinary pleasure to welcome you to the Mandragora soiree. Tonight, I particularly recommend you direct your attention to the performances prepared by artists of our community.
Mm-hmm.
Tell us about these performances.
This evening, the Mandragora has the honor to present three superb displays of artistry. The first was a concert by Cecilia Belont, a singer whose voice, were it stone,
ooh,
sadly, Mademoiselle Cecilia has sung.
Shame. You would have loved to hear her.
Luckily, you are in time to see the great Calesti, a master of visual illusions, come to us from far off afar.
Visual illusions. Interesting. And the third artist?
The third and fourth, for they are a duo, are the Tuven brothers, presenting their newest pantomime.
Huh?
We were really hoping to meet Cecilia Belont.
You are admirers, I surmise. I'm certain you will have ample opportunity to converse with her.
Oh, we will!
It cannot be easy to identify anyone in this crowd. Perhaps you could help us find her.
I don't know where she is now, but I can give you a clue.
Let's hear it.
Seek the Kaviri Orchid.
Meaning?
Cecilia wears one in her hair. You shall recognize her easily by the orchid.
Well, well. Dandelion's always complaining about artists being poor as temple mice.
Mm-hmm.
The residence belongs to none of them. They are guests here.
Isn't that the Novigrad? Fucking...
Woman in the black dress. There, on the balcony.
Got her. Doesn't wear a mask?
It would be pointless. All would know her anyway.
Kaviri Orchid. Let's look for it. If we find Cecilia, we'll find the Cintrian.
You know, we might as...
Come, let's look in the alcoves.
Yeah, but we gotta take part in the soiree's entertainments. There might be, like, Gwent going on here.
Go on, Geralt, be bold. Show us the artist in you. The paintballs, cast them at the canvas.
Come, toss some paint.
Ha!
Folk, yet another soul longing to express its creative side.
Well,
ha!
Drop them in the pail.
It's a manifestation of the man's soul.
Blue blood is all ice.
Ha!
Should you tire of these hues?
Ha!
Drop them in the pail and grab a different one.
Yeah!
It represents transgression in its purest form.
Yeah! I'll need some green here. All the way to the side of here.
Lush and verdant as a field of vines. To vines and to wine! The composition takes shape.
Yes, it's sure to be a masterpiece.
Red. See, we're going in here from the side here. You can see where I'm going with this, hopefully. Now we got two more purples here. I know. Look at this. Look at this. Look at where I'm going with this. You can't even see where I'm going with this. Ah.
The continual battle between good and evil, and defiance.
Oh yes, that's him all right. Good versus evil. The dualistic nature of man.
Yep.
And defiance.
Sure to be in one of the alcoves. It must be someone famous, I think. Such talent.
Absent. The preferred hooch of artists.
Careful. Packs a pretty powerful punch.
That's fine.
Built up a pretty powerful resistance.
All right, let's go.
Your thoughts, as you've made no effort to understand, it's a metaphor of the constant struggle for power and influence.
Come, let's look in the alcove.
What else should they think of? If they can't agree, they ought to cut the line.
Sure. Why aren't any of these artists playing Gwent? Well, let me ask you that.
Look at the mage. I believe he's casting spells.
Yeah, we'll see.
Sure to be in one of the the dolphins. That is no ordinary illusion. The man is a true artist.
Mm-hmm. Impressive.
Sure.
Where are you?
Look, lanterns. They say releasing them brings good luck.
Let's release one.
Fine. Let's give it a try.
Never suspected you believed in such things.
And so all the lanterns shall fly. Geralt, it's... You're not being very inconspicuous, I'll give you that.
Aren't they even?
Okay. It's on the second floor we gotta go to. Is there a hidden stairs? Oh, hang on.
Do not disturb. Shoo, shoo.
Mm-hmm. It's the right flower.
Of course it is. A Kaviri orchid lends just the right contrast to her complexion.
Need to talk to your model. It'll only take a minute.
To me?
Lie still! You may speak, but for love's sake, do not move.
Wow. Impressive portrait.
I know the style, the stroke. This is Dorian Velez.
The gracious lady has heard of me?
I've heard... Anna Henrietta herself wished you to paint her portrait once.
At one point, the palace chamberlain even wrote to me, but alas, ultimately refused my terms.
What was the matter?
When he learned I only ever paint nudes, he severed all contact. He said he would not dare offend her illustrious highness with such a proposition.
Ouch.
I've always longed to paint her. Such a shame.
I think you may still get your chance.
We came here to meet you, specifically.
To meet me? But why?
Cintrian Noble you came here with. Wanted to ask you about him.
Cintrian Noble? Ah! You must think I'm Cecilia.
Orchid confused me.
I told you not to move!
As she concluded her performance, Cecilia tossed the flower into the crowd. I caught it, but I did see the nobleman.
Really liked to talk to him. What did he look like?
Like many here. Tall, dark, masked.
Know where he might be now?
He gave Cecilia a small gift, a heart-shaped box. Then they strolled off together towards the refreshment tables. Mm.
Excuse me, madame, monsieur, I cannot work like this. You must leave now.
All right.
We should walk past the tables. Perhaps they're still there.
Can I get that, Oh, God, this guy's freaking out!
Someone left their loot behind. Looks a little like dandelions.
This was scratched. Someone beat him with it once.
Empty heart-shaped box. Cecilia must have left it behind.
It looks like it held a flask of perfume. A gift from the Cintrian, I imagine.
Scent still hangs in the air. Let's follow it. Bit of Fistech. Artist's way of numbing their existential pain.
I do not even wish to comment.
Love letter penned on a napkin. Look.
Oh, my amour, my sunbeam flittering across the firmament of my life. Treacly refuse.
Such talent. Exceptional, true. And I would have ever loved to meet him. It's a shame he didn't come alone.
Need I remind you that neither...
The scent still hangs in the air. So Geralt, you can just smell it? Yeah, I'm just... Whatever, you just... I'm just gonna follow you. You just do your thing. If I was a normal person, witchers would spook the heck out of me. Let me tell you what. Well, I am a normal person. But a normal person in that universe, I guess.
Don't worry.
How can you be so sure?
Now, stop summoning dolphins, guy.
Sorry, only artists in the Mandragora allowed.
Come, we must consider what to do.
I'm just gonna mind fuck him.
I'd recognize that voice anywhere.
You You must be mistaking me for someone else.
I served 15 years in the palace. Your Grace, I'd not mistake you for anyone.
Shh! Not so loud. We are here incognito, on state business.
Yes, Your Grace. How may I serve?
Well, first of all, don't tell anyone you've seen us.
I hope we can count on your discretion.
Of course. I shall be silent as the grave.
Looking for Cecilia Bellant. Seen her?
She's in her dressing room, where she went with a nobleman. They clearly were drawn to each other.
What did the man look like?
Tall, broad-shouldered. A black beard peeping out from under his mask, and he spoke with a foreign accent, a drawl of sorts.
That must be him. We must get to the dressing room, quickly.
Yes, Your Grace. I'll take you.
No, stay here. Anyone tries to flee, you stop them.
Understood.
Alright.
Quickly, upstairs.
Hang on.
On, Witcher.
You're leading! Locked.
That must be Cecilia.
No pulse. We're too late.
He slit her throat. The brute.
Didn't go out the door. Guard would have noticed. Might still be somewhere here.
You must find him before he harms another. I shall alert Oriana at once. She should bring her soiree to a close.
Shouldn't split up.
Geralt, I will be fine. Go after that rogue. I shall fetch help.
Hey. Ah, I'm so strong. You got superpowers, lady? You don't. You ain't got superpowers.
Killed her.
Any other clues here? Nah, just treasures.
Bloody handprint. Mm-hmm. It's his. Tore down the door. Made a platform. Clever. Broke the flower pot strong to the door. Then stepped in the soil. Footprints. Made by soiled boots. Must have climbed this ladder.
Duk 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 duk.
Could still be here. Need to stay alert. Smashed mirror. Someone crashed into it hard, then sank to the floor.
I swear to God, Regis, if you're here.
Blood stains. Of a snap chain. Jewel must have been on it. Precious stone. Bloody fingerprint on it. Thief came for this. Must have. Tiny chain links next to it. From a snapped necklace. Seems there was a struggle. Jewelry box. Locks busted. Picked open, probably. Sconce is bent, smeared with blood. Someone tried to grab it. Blood on the window frame. Someone climb out, fall out.
Maybe.
Looks valuable, but it's not what he came for. Empty inkwell, knocked over, turned toward the room. Canvas is cut. Somebody took a knife to the painting, looks like. Locked. And no key in sight.
I see no more clues. Is it just me?
Sconce is bent, smeared with blood. Someone try to grab it.
I probably shouldn't do that. Oh, there we go.
Hunting knife, richly ornamented. Used during the fight, probably. Jewel was in the box, it seems. Cintrian tried to steal it, but someone got in his way. They fought, struggled, that's clear. Ended with one of them flying out the window. Fall had to have killed them. Jewel's still here, though, so our Cintrian must have been the flyer.
So, this is the tracker. A witcher, yes?
Indeed, this is him. We found the body together. Then he set off in pursuit of the killer.
Oh, for a minute I didn't recognize.
But I've only found evidence of a fight. Seems the Cintrians killed his last. Finally failed this time. Shame it happened too late for Cecilia.
Poor girl. Always told her she chose her males badly. But I would never have suspected she could arrive with a murderer. I'll alert the staff. Have them see to her body at once. Meanwhile, we should sit. I will tell you everything in full detail.
I guess. You sure? Appreciate that. Oh, it's so cold.
I caught him red-handed, attempting to burgle, rifling through my possessions.
What did you do? Summon the guards?
There was no time. I feared he'd escape, refused to give him the chance. He stood with his back to me, so I attacked. He struck his head on a picture frame as we struggled. He was bleeding, dazed, and then he drew a knife. Everything happened very quickly then. I knocked the weapon out of his hand and pushed him hard. He
fell out of the window.
Just so.
None too wise picking a fight with an armed robber.
Why? Because I'm a woman, in a frock rather than plate. I can take care of myself, I assure you. A hairpin might look like mere ornament, but plunged into an eye, it can be as effective as a blade.
All right.
Claim the man was trying to rob you when you walked into the room?
Yes. He stood over my dressing table, pouring through my jewelry.
Mm-hmm. After this is my guess. Picked it up while searching.
Why, that's the heart of Toussaint. Oriana, how did you ever come to have it?
I bought it many years ago from a young woman.
Legally!
Jewel seems important. Why?
The heart is an heirloom. It belonged to my family for years. Then it disappeared. I didn't think we would ever recover it.
Seems someone is very determined to find it. The thief left his tool bag behind. Found this drawing inside it. Look.
Is that some spilled wine as well on the paper?
The heart of Toussaint. Representation's pretty faithful. Cintrian must have been on a job. Got very clear instructions what to look for.
So it is not him we seek, but his employer. Is this the only evidence we found?
Also happened on the weapon he attacked Oriana with. Hunting knife. Used to skin game. Got an emblem on its hilt.
This crest is used by the Lords of Duntine. The present master of the castle is a passionate hunter. Our next lead, perhaps.
Duntine. Remember the place. Abandoned ruin just a few years ago.
More recently, the family's last heir. Roderick returned to his ancestral seat and restored the castle.
Know any more about this Roderick?
His grandfather was an advisor to Queen Ademarta. The family received those lands as a grant for his service. Roderick is quite the recluse. He avoids society, preferring the company of a small team of knights, though the latter term is imprecise, as they seem more akin to vandals with crests on their shields.
Hmm.
Oriana. Everything we discussed here, Hope you'll keep it to yourself. Counting on it, in fact. Word gets out he, failed in his attempt to steal the jewel. His employer could run. We need to proceed cautiously.
Discretion is in the interest of us all. I'll not ask what this is about, just as I expect not to be troubled about it again. By anyone.
Forgive me, Madam Oriana, but might I have a word?
You must excuse me a moment.
Ah, no one suspects the henchman. He's the villain! Easily, I solved the mystery.
Oriana, any thoughts?
Few make me feel awkward, but in her presence, I sense anxiety, discomfort.
The drawing. It's on the same type of paper the victims' names were written on. Drawn with the same ink, too. Seems the work of our blackmailers.
Who were not only behind the beast's murders, but also stole the Son Real and sought to steal the heart of Toussaint.
Look, the wine, the jewel, both tied to you intrinsically. Coincidence? Not something I'm willing to believe. Worried about one thing. That somewhere at the end of this scheme, plan might call for an attempt on your life.
It could be something else altogether.
Maybe, I don't know.
My sister, Siana, might be among the schemers.
Vampire!
She left court when we were children. My parents banished her from the duchy. I've not seen her since.
What did your sister do to get banished?
Siana was cursed.
Vampire!
Parents run afoul of some mage?
No. She was born at an inopportune moment. They said she was touched by the curse of the Black Sun. Geralt, is it true? Can an individual be evil because they were born during the wrong lunar phase?
Could be the case. Could also be because they were treated like lepers from birth. Isolated, prodded, ostracized. Couldn't have had it easy, Siana.
She was angry at the whole world. She felt inferior, felt pain, though she masked this with confidence, arrogance even. She could also be cruel at times. I recall one such situation. She persuaded Cedric the Coolbert that she could see the future in her dreams. We were children, and Cedric's brother was smitten with me. It was an innocent childhood crush. Siana knew of it. She told Cedric of a dream she had had, that he would die at the hands of his own brother. Cedric stole his father's sword and killed his brother. She destroyed two lives with a prank. Cedric mourns to this day.
Hey, it seems like a tard. I don't know.
They forced her to leave the palace. A decade passed. More. I've missed her terribly since.
Think your sister might be involved? Why?
You see, I recall her always being rather possessive, throwing jealous fits if I had something she didn't.
Here, that's normal for sisters. Rivalry.
True. I suppose I gave as good as I got. There are times I miss that very much. The wine, its theft, was the first clue. That's very much like her. She always did enjoy stealing my toys. But I grew almost certain when I saw the heart of Toussaint. Siana received it from father as a gift. At a time when my parents thought of her as but an ill-behaved little girl, someone wanted some of my wine. The same someone ordered our family jewels stolen or recovered. It's my sister. It must be.
A fallen princess satisfying whims, going after lost luxuries? Could be right.
I don't know.
Your mission has gained new import. You must go to Dun Tyne, and if Siana is there, you must find her. No matter what she did, she is not to be harmed in any way, shape, or form. You must make sure of that.
I mean, my axie is okay. But, I mean, is it that good? And if she's a vampire, I'm sure she's a fucking vampire. Then I don't know, man. Can I promise that? But maybe that's just, maybe she just wants to hear that. Yeah, whatever.
I'll find her if she's there.
I hope you do. I very much wish to talk to her, sister to sister.
Your Grace, Geralt, I'd like to introduce...
Regis! What a surprise! I had no idea you were in Beauclair. And this is...
Detlaf.
my very dear friend, Detlaf van der Eritain, an arrival from Nazaire. We are lending our combined resources to the Witch's Hunt.
Ah, yes. Splendid. But why are you here at Oriana's?
Vampire!
To pay me a surprise visit, so I invited Regis in for a glass of wine. We've known each other...
Fucking vampire! I knew it! I was about to say that.
Witcher, I hear you know Regis too. Even that you are friends.
Seem surprised. Why?
I never would have suspected Regis to find common ground with a Witcher.
Don't be fooled, dear. Geralt has many merits. He merely hides them from the world very diligently.
You said you're both aiding him with his contract.
I don't like that guy standing behind me.
Beauclair, I suspect. Master Witcher, maybe you could satisfy my curiosity. What's it like going toe to toe with a monster? Knowing you've only two options, to kill or be killed.
Despite what you might have heard, I don't lunge at every monster I see, sword in hand. Talking gets the job done for some.
I wonder what a monster might have to say to you.
It might want to apologize.
My word. For what might a monster wish to apologize to a Witcher?
For killing, though at times there is no choice, when loved ones are at risk and require protection.
Same as humans. Put them in that situation, they'll kill too.
You understand this. It must be why you and Regis are friends. If I understand you correctly, you would rather help a monster than kill it.
If possible, yeah. Or at least try.
Enough about the Witcher trade for now. Regis mentioned you come from Nazaire. I spent time there as a child.
Fond memories?
It was wonderful. I was positively entranced by the land's fashions. Deep-cut dresses I found most fascinating.
I believe we're running short on wine. I should go to the cellar, bring another bottle.
Let me go. Want to help Regis? Know your wine a lot better than I know mine.
We shall return forthwith. An exceptional conversation, don't you think? Vampires, a witcher, and the Duchess of Toussaint? My, my.
Highly exceptional, Regis. Wanted to talk to you in private. You crazy bringing Detlaf here?
Geralt, allow me to explain.
No, let me explain. He's dangerous, and you are gonna watch him.
But that is precisely what I'm doing. Detlaf believes you'll succeed in your task, and he'll not need to kill anymore.
That is, not until he gets his hands on the men who kidnapped his Renner.
Guessing it's no accident you two stopped by.
It would be quite some coincidence indeed. No, a dutiful little bird told us.
Oriana, she really your friend? Can she be trusted?
I met her years ago, before I met you. And before she settled in Beauclair, we'd not seen one another in... I can't begin to tell you in how long.
But I shall tell you all about her some other day.
Vampire!
Listen close. Managed to learn where the blackmailers are. They're based at Duntyne Castle.
That's splendid news. If they are there, Renner must be there as well.
We don't know that.
I just expect we'll find her long-lost sister there, too. Thing is, she might be involved. Could be behind the blackmailing.
Do you mean to say your task now is to extract two women from the castle?
Mean to say we can't breathe a word of this to Detlaff, who wants revenge above all else.
Geralt, you must trust me. I've got a way with...
No, Regis. Can't risk it. Gotta keep Detlaff here while I go to Duntine.
Alone?
Alone. That way I can make sure neither woman will come to any harm.
I hope you know what you're doing. Fine. I shall see to Detlaff. Good luck, my friend.
Splendidly, Detlaff. Ah, I'm grateful you brought back those memories. You're back. It took you long enough.
Contrary to what common folk believe, choosing a wine is not nearly as easy as it might seem. Especially a wine to be served to two exquisite ladies.
Regis, gallant as ever. I regret all the more that I shan't finish the second bottle with you. Duty calls.
Your grace, always a pleasure.
I thank you for your help. It's been invaluable. Geralt, will you see me out?
Nah, she knows something's up. She's like, nah, scratching her nose there.
You have exceptional friends. This Detlaff, an intriguing man, to say the least.
To say the least.
Don't know him too well. He say much about himself?
Not much, but I've a good sense of the true nature of those I meet. I'd not survive a week at court otherwise.
So what's his?
Sensitive. Sad. He carries within him the weight of a terrible tragedy. He is a good man, but lost, which is why he comes across as grim.
Didn't expect the evening to end like this.
Neither did I. But I have not drawn you out for a romantic stroll. I wish to make certain you know what you are to do.
Mm-hmm. Gotta go to Duntine.
I've decided my guardsmen will support you. You will meet them at Count Lacroix's. It stands along the Saint Retour River, near the Cockatrice Inn. Captain de la Tour and his men will await you there at midnight. You shall storm the castle together.
I can do this myself. I'm really overpowered. It's really quite all right. Nah, got my swords. Alright, let's put our clothes back on, Jesus. I feel naked. There we go. Looks good. Looks good. Oh, shit. There we go. Forty-seven. See how Marlene is doing. You know what? Let's see how she's doing. Let's just do a little side stroll before we end the episode. I know the episode's dragging on, but let's do it. Poor gal. Maybe she'll, she'll just be my little... she will be a little help around the house. Oh. Maybe she will.
I do not know how I will ever repay you, Witcher.
Don't expect to be paid. Hope you're feeling better, that's all.
Oh, yes, I feel my strength returning thanks chiefly to Barnabas Basil's care.
Ah, Basil.
The deal you endured. Glad I cut it short.
Yes. Years of suffering. You know what was worse than the hunger? Watching my loved ones, my children grow old and die. All my family's long gone now. The last of my kin perished decades past. I fear I've nowhere to go.
Stay here.
This is a big house, big estate. You can stay here.
Truly? never infringe so on your...
You stay here.
Mentality.
You stay here.
Yet...
Yeah.
After all I've suffered, the years of starvation, I've but one dream. At last to prepare food that fortifies, nourishes, to delight in the tastes and smells of spices, to sit at one table with others and eat.
Don't see a problem if that's your dream. You could help Barnabas Basil in the kitchen. Eating his meals. You know he's not a culinary virtuoso.
Nothing could make me happier. Thank you.
No, thank you. House could use a woman's touch.
I've one other thing I'd like to tell you. Many years ago, my father assembled valuables for my diary. I never wed, so they remained unclaimed. These baubles are no use to me now, but to you, well, perhaps let them be a token of my gratitude. If you wish to find them, you must go to my old home, to Trastamara. The dowry lies hidden in a barrel in the cellar. There are several barrels. You must give each a knock until you find the right one.
That's sneaky.
Just that. Thanks. I'd never expect someone with your past to feel drawn to the kitchen.
Do you fear I will cook in your home as I brewed as a white?
Counting on you having slightly better taste as a human.
Of that, you can be sure. I loved cooking, even as a child. My gran was a true master in the kitchen. Her spit-roasted ox was famed throughout the land.
Thought you were a lady, owned an estate.
Do you mean to say a woman of my rank should have had a cook? You're right, of course. And I had the best of cooks. But I devised the dishes myself. They only prepared them.
Little culinary genius here. I've always wanted to have like a whole pig or something, you know, on a spit. You know, but you gotta set aside a whole day for that, so that's not gonna happen.
You sure you don't feel lonely out here?
I cannot say yet. Too little time has passed since you freed me of my thrall, but somehow, for now at least, I do not feel drawn to the city, to others.
Visited others' homes as a white?
Yes, but ever at night, when all were asleep, I went in search of spoons.
Remember, you can always change your mind. Decide you've lived here long enough, just say the word.
I'd never wish to seem ungrateful.
And I'd never want you to stay against your will. See you later.
Take care, Witcher. And remember, you always have warm food awaiting
so nice. Your return. So nice. Got anything to say about
Sir,
that, Basil?
A shipment of wine from the Belgard vineyard, I believe.
Yeah.
Madame Matilda and Monsieur Liam. I had the barrels unloaded and stored in the cellar to the right of the entrance.
The White Wolf.
Take a look when I have a moment.
Splendid. I was told to expect a subsequent delivery 5 days hence.
Thanks.
So in the cellar, to the right of the entrance. Huh. I pay attention. What was it we could do with this? I forgot. Oh, yeah. We could dismantle these mutagens. Can I dismantle a bunch at a time? Yeah, we can. Boom. Get boomed. All right. Well, guys, I think that, what's that symbol? What does that mean? Little alchemy. Maybe it's in the...
I thank you for letting me stay. I cannot remember. remember when last I was this happy.
See you later.
Take care with...
Yep. How nice. How nice. My home is really shaping up, you know? I could live here. That's what I'd say. But I think it'd be very humid. I wouldn't like that. I wouldn't like that. Alright, guys. Thanks for watching. And next time, I think we're gonna do some side quests. That's what it seems like. We got a lot of side quests here. So, let's do that. We are also, I guess, gonna be doing both hunts. Why not? And I'll do these treasure hunts on my own time, because that's meh. Whatever. So, thanks for watching, and tune into the next.